Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1505, Next Invoice Number. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin from MrExcel.com. Question sent in today is, how do I generate the next invoice number? I set up an invoice. How do we make it generate the next invoice number? Well, first of all, when you start with an invoice, that's easy. File, new, out here in Office Online, they have all kinds of invoices to choose from. There's folders and folders of these. I'll just choose one at random. The concepts here are going to be similar no matter which one you choose. All right, so we've opened that from Office Online. Obviously, some customizations here. You're going to go through and put your company name, address, and all that stuff. But figure out where the invoice number is. And I don't like this. They put the invoice number in square brackets. That's kind of weird. I'm going to put 23451, so it's actually numeric. And I'm going to remember that that is cell E5. Okay, now, I pulled this down and I need to save it. Right now it's in compatibility mode, so it's actually will work for Excel 2003. I want to do File Save As. Save this on my local machine and make sure that it's a macro-enabled workbook. If you usually save things as Excel workbooks, you need to go macro-enabled. We'll just call it Mr. Excel Invoice. Cool. All right. So now we have a local copy saved and macros are legal. Now, to get over to the macro language, we're going to do Alt F11. Don't be afraid of this. It's just a tiny bit of code. If you've never been to the macro language before, it opens up to this big gray screen, View, Project Explorer. In the Project Explorer, find the project called whatever you saved it as. And then we're going to insert a module. We're going to create two macros. Sub, Next Invoice. All right. And what we do is we say range E5.value is equal to range E5.value plus 1. All right, now, whichever invoice you download, you're going to have to figure out where that invoice number is. In my case, it's E5. In some other invoices, it might be C3 or Z42. Who knows? Whatever that range is, you're going to put that range there and there. Also, a little bit more here. I don't want to just put the next invoice number in. I want to clear out all of the stuff that I entered previously. And for me, the salesperson and due date, I'm going to leave those like they were before. But I want to clear out everything from A20 down to E39. You see there's formulas over here. I don't want to clear out those. So A20 to E39, A20:E39.ClearContents. So that will clear any contents. So now we have this macro that's going to increment the invoice number. Let's figure out a way to run that. Easiest way to run it is just to put any kind of a shape on the sheet. Insert a shape. You can choose wherever you like. The circle, the star. Oh, hey, let's use the lightning bolt. That'll be fun. So just draw a little lightning bolt over here. And let's see if you want to do the shape fill. Feel free to do that. But the most important part, right click and say assign macro. And it's going to be to our next invoice. All right, so now we put in, someone bought 5 copies of pivot table data crunching. At $34.95. All right, beautiful. Now we want to clear that out and put the next invoice number in. Click the lightning bolt. Aha, next invoice. That stuff is cleared out. So that's good. The other thing I really want to do here is I want to save a copy of all the previous invoices. And there's actually a page out at MrExcel.com with this next little bit of code. So I'm going to press Alt F11, and I just copied to the clipboard the code that I've written previously. And what this does is it takes the active worksheet here and it copies it to a brand new workbook, and then it creates an invoice, a file name based on the invoice number. So in my case, I'm going to C:\AAA. In your case, put the right folder and path there. And then I want to start out with the letters INV, the invoice number, and .xlsx, active workbook.save as, the file name, and then I want to use an xlsx, that's the macro free version, and then close that temporary version, and then go back and run next invoice. Okay, so let's go back and assign this to a shape. So I'll do insert shapes, and let's call this. Text box here, save and clear. Again, right click, assign macro, save invoice with new name, click OK. All right, now before we run this, and make a copy. I need to make sure, it's really important that you save this workbook, so that way we save the version with macros. Alright, so we have Mr. Excel Invoice, and I'm going to click Save and Clear. Actually, we'll put just something here to test it. Our Excel from Mr. Excel, 39.95, we're at 23452. I click Save and Clear. Alright, so you see that we're now at the next invoice number. We've now cleared things out. And if I look at my recent file list, invoice 23452 saved just a minute ago. So a very simple way with these two macros, two tiny little macros here, about 10 lines of code, to take one of the invoices from Office Online, customize it, and have yourself a great little system to add the invoice number and also give you a way to save all previous invoices. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.